certain you know me. You know my lying down and my rising up. You understand all my thoughts from afar, and you're acquainted with all my ways. Oh, you're searching, you know me. Oh, you're searching, you know me. You know my lying down and my rising up. You understand all my thoughts from afar, and you're acquainted with all my ways. Nothing is hidden from you, Father. Even when we were hidden in our mother's womb and nobody could see us, we were not hidden from you. And even in times still in our life, there's so many parts of who we are that are hidden. But you know them because you know us intimately. We praise you because you are intimate. We welcome your intimacy in our worship. Come and shine your light in the deepest parts of our being. Let your truth minister to our souls, to our emotions and our mind. Let it fill our whole beings. In the secret place of my mother's womb. In the secret place of my mother's womb, you saw me, and everything you knew. There you took your time to patiently mold me. Every part is divine, so I praise you. Yes, I do. I am fearfully and wonderfully made to be like you, so I praise you. Yes, I do. How marvelous and wonderful is everything you do. La, la, la. It was so ordinary, the way I came to be, boy to man, and now here I stand. But now I've come to realize there's much more to me. I'm a son of Elohim, and I praise you. Yes, I do. I am fearfully and wonderfully made to be like you, so I praise you. Yes, I do. How marvelous and wonderful is everything you do. Yes, I do. I am fearfully and wonderfully made to be like you. I praise you. Yes, I do. From before there was time, day you had in mind. So I praise you, yes I do. Here's just one tiny grain of sand in an ocean of your thoughts of me. Where can I go from your spirit? Even if I make my bed in hell, you are there. You have never abandoned us. You have never left us or forsaken us. And we give you praise. What a wonderful Father. Thank you, Father. We've been through some dark times, but you have never left us. Thoughts have always been on us. Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from you? Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from you? When I awake, I find I'm still with you. So I praise you, yes I do. I am fearfully and wonderfully made to be like you. So I praise you, yes I do. How marvelous and wonderful is everything you do. Scriptures make it very clear who are the blessed ones, who are the happy ones. This is from Matthew 5. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will find comfort. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will find comfort. Hallelujah. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, they will be called the sons of Yah. Blessed are the merciful, for they will find mercy. Those who hunger for righteousness, they will be filled. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, they will be called the sons of Yah. And even if they should hate you for my name's sake, rejoice and be glad. Great is your reward. So rejoice and be thankful with the highest joy. Your King is coming, and great will be your reward. Yours is the kingdom. You will see Yah. You will be called the sons of Yah. Yours is the kingdom. You will see Yah. You will be called the sons of Yah. Sons of Yah. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see Yah. Blessed are the peacemakers, they will be called the sons of Yah. And it's time for the sons of Yah to be revealed. Manifest your nature and your people like never before, Father. Bring us into maturity. Everyone connected to the head, Mashiach. Every joint, every ligament, every limb supplying. Bring together the dismembered parts of your body. And let us not be tossed to and fro again by every wind of doctrine. Give back a spirit of discernment to your people, that they would know your voice. My sheep know me, and they hear my voice, they know my voice. Expose the false shepherds in our midst. Give us ears to hear your voice, your sweet, smooth voice, for your words are like honey. Your words are smooth and full of grace and truth and wisdom. How we need your words of life. Sons, you have all. This is who you are, oh children of Yah. This is who you are and what you will become when you see Him as He is. Greater is He who is living in you than the wicked one who is in the world. Let him who fears be perfected in your love. For we love him with the love he first loved us. For he laid down his life. This is how we know love. They will know that we belong to Him when we love each other. O children of Yah, beloved sons, you have overcome. The battle has been won. For greater is He who is living in you than the who is in the world. You have love kicks out all fear. So the answer to fear is love. Oh, that you would know the heights and the depths of this love. That you may be filled to the measure of the fullness of Elohim. For he who fears has not been perfected in love. So, Father, comfort our hearts with your love. Have mercy on us. For we shrivel up and die without your love, without your presence, without your words of life. Perfect love has no fear. There is no fear in love. Perfect love has no fear. There is no fear in love. There is no darkness in Him. There is no darkness in Him. There is no fear. There is no fear in love. There is no darkness in Him. There is no darkness in Him. There is no fear in love. Let not any man say, I'm tempted by Elohim to do evil. For Elohim tempts no one with evil. There is no darkness in Him. There is no fear in love. Let him who fears be perfected in your love. For we love Him with the love He first loved us. Perfect love has no fear. There is no fear in love. There is no fear. Truth, and the truth shall set you free. And he who the Son sets free is free indeed. You don't need religion. You need Him. And they will know that we belong. By how we love each other. For the broken
Spirit.
within me. And Father, rebuild us and all that's been lost. The bells ringing, they're singing that you can be born again. Hear the bells ringing, they're singing that He is risen from the dead. The angel upon the tombstone said He has risen just as He said. Now go tell our disciples that Yeshua is no longer dead. Joy to the world, He has risen. Hallelujah, He's risen. Hallelujah, He's risen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The shofar is sounding, the heavens announcing the day has come. The sign is appearing, the heavens revealing the Son of Man. He's sending out His servants to gather the outcasts of Israel. Quickly now, go tell all the exiles that Babylon is finally no more. Rejoice, all you righteous, He's coming. Hallelujah, He's coming. Hallelujah, He's coming. He's coming. Shofar is sounding, the heavens announcing the day has come. The sign is appearing, the heavens revealing the Son of Man. He's coming to judge and make war on the nations, the beasts and the whore. Hurry now, go out to meet Him. The wedding feast is now near at hand. Rejoice, rejoice, all you righteous, He's coming. Hallelujah, He's coming. Hallelujah, He's coming. He's coming, He's coming, He's coming, He's coming, He's coming. Though the nations rage and breathe out their lies, the banner he's raising up high. The kingdoms of this world are now the kingdoms of Elohim. The kingdoms of Elohim. He's coming. It's coming. It's coming. His kingdom is coming. Rejoice, all you righteous. Rejoice, all you righteous. He's coming. Hallelujah. He's coming. Hallelujah. He's coming. The scepter of the wicked will not remain over the righteous. When he comes, we will declare that his judgments are true and righteous. Song of Moshe is a song for the last generation of this age. For they will have the testimony of Yeshua, and they will keep the commandments given to us by Moshe. These are the ones that overcome. We're gonna sing. We're gonna shout the song of the ones who overcome. The song of the Lamb, the song of Moshe, the song of the ones who overcome. How great and how marvelous are all of your words, King of the righteous and King of all kings. All nations will come and worship you. That's right. All nations will come and worship you. All nations will come and worship you. Sing and we're gonna shout the song of the ones who overcome. Is we're gonna the song of the Lamb, the song of Moshe, the song of the ones who overcome. Yes, we give you praise and we give you thanks. For in your great power you come to reign. Who will not fear you and glorify your name? Your judgments are righteous and true are your ways. All nations will come and worship you. Right here in this city, they will come. All nations will come and worship you. Yes, they will. Yes, they will. All nations will come. All peoples will bow. All nations will come and worship you. And who will not fear you and glorify your name? King of the righteous, true are your ways. All nations will come and worship you. Every tribe and tongue. All nations will come and worship you. For you are King of kings and Lord of lords. All nations will come and worship you. All nations will come and worship you. We worship you here, O King. We worship you in the city of the great King. We name you the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. Only you are worthy to take the throne in Jerusalem. Only you are holy. Only you are worthy, O the Lamb that was slain. Only you are worthy. Only you are worthy. Take up your throne. And that's why we can't forget Jerusalem. Because the marriage of the Lamb is going to be here. And this is going to be the place of His throne. That's why we remember Jerusalem. As we turn our hearts towards Jerusalem, we prepare the way for the coming of the Messiah. And this time, He's coming as King. He's going to smash the nations like a potter's vessel. He will rule them with a rod of iron. For Yahweh will set His King, the one He has appointed, His anointed one, on His holy mountain. And who will not fear Him? All nations will worship Him, who was and is to come. The Lamb that was slain before the foundation of the world. And every eye will see Him. Even the ones who pierced Him. If I forget you, O Jerusalem, may I lose my right hand. If I don't praise you, O Jerusalem, let my tongue cease to move. Even though I land Jerusalem, Dibbah Tishkach Yemini. Even though I land Jerusalem. Tidbak leshoni lechiki. Im lo ale Jerusalem. Im lo ale Jerusalem. Awosh simchati, awosh simchati. So let his righteousness shine forth as the brightness of a lamp that burns. Let her be praised in all the earth till her streets are filled with joy. Shine forth even now in our day, even in this hour, in this jubilee of the restoration of Jerusalem, in this jubilee from 1967 when it was united once again under the hands of the Jewish people. In this day, Father, give mercy to your city, cause her to shine like never before. Let your righteousness go forth. Let a new wind of your Ruach blow from this place. Let a new fire fall in this place. A fresh fire from you, from heaven. So let her righteousness shine forth as the brightness of a lamp that burns. Let her burn. Be praised in all the earth till her streets are filled with joy. Oh, the city of the great King deserves to be exalted, deserves to be praised, deserves to be filled with your praises. This city deserves your praises. So we praise you in the city of the great King. We make your praise great. We make your name great. Sanctify your name in this place. Sanctify your name. will not be moved. She will not be moved. Because you chose her long ago. And she will not be forsaken. You have loved her. And you are longing for the day when you can take your people in your arms again in this city. For this is where your arms will embrace your people like never before. This is where your presence is manifested like never before. For this is the place of your name. Your eyes and your heart are attentive to the prayers in this place. You know, so many times when I'm singing about Jerusalem, you know, all these thousands of people that have never even been here, they're stirred in their spirits. Because our spirits know that this city is called out from all other cities and has an incredible destiny. And Father, to deny the right of this city to be exalted as the city of the great King is like to deny our spirits. And when we deny this city its rightful place, it's like we're cutting our own right hand off. It's like we're losing the authority in our voice. But as we turn our hearts back to your city, because you love it, we're restored in our spirits to a whole new level. And we're brought closer together. It's more than just a physical place, although it is. It's a manifestation of your throne room on earth. Though she is abandoned and forsaken and desolate, and many people, even in the churches, have said you have forgotten her, the truth is you have not. And even though she is wounded and beaten down, and she's oppressed by all kinds of religious oppression, financial oppression, you declare her beautiful and chosen. You will take this desolation. You will take this desolation and turn it into praise and turn it into glory. You will take this big mass of destruction, for she is still desolate. Even since Yeshua's time, she is still desolate. Since 70 AD, she is still desolate. The pain is still here. The ashes are still here. She is still oppressed by the nations. But the Father says, no more. No more will you have my city. I'm taking her back. Stone by stone. Person by person. And no unclean thing will come in her anymore. And we declare to the heavenly realm, this city belongs to the great and awesome King. Let her righteousness shine forth as the brightness of a lamp that burns. Let her be praised in all the earth till her streets are filled with joy. Thank you. before Jerusalem needs to be in our prayers. We think we know Jerusalem with all of its ancient architecture and churches and mosques and all that. We don't know Jerusalem if we're just looking at that. Anybody who's feeling a drawing to physically come here and visit this city, especially during the feast times, you are being led by the Ruach. This is the hour when He is drawing His people back to His city. There are so many psalms even written all about in relation to that pilgrimage to Jerusalem. It's all over our scriptures, and it hasn't changed. I believe that every believer needs to be prepared to come to this city one day. Blessed is the man in whose heart is the highways to Zion, and whose heart is set on pilgrimage, whose heart is set on one day being in Jerusalem and worshiping the King. There's a blessing when your heart is set on that. Even if you can't come right now, begin to set your hearts towards this place. There's a blessing. It's totally scriptural, and it's time to change our thinking. Now I'm preaching. Hallelujah. So, Father, oh, how I long to gather you in my arms like a mother hen gathers her chicks. We remember those words that you said right here in Jerusalem. You said those words over Jerusalem. You wept over this city. How I long to gather my arms and hold you. How I long to gather you in my arms and hold you. I am waiting for your return. I am waiting for your return. Israel, my firstborn son. You are Israel, my chosen one. And how I long to gather you in my arms and hold you. I am waiting for your return. This is the time of your